Okay, well, I'm really glad Jacinda's got it, because now I have nothing to say. basically come away from our mini comp and hear someone talk so enthusiastically about it, so it'll be $100 from later. My name's Andy. I'm probably the president of the Melbourne Hackerspace, but really just one of the hackers there, and it's basically a personal invitation for everyone to come along to the Hackerspace. Basically, they're fun. I think pretty much ended my presentation there. But it's an environment which you can learn new skills. You can challenge yourself by building and creating things you might not otherwise do by yourself. What surprised me a lot is the social aspect. Currently, it's a lot of guys in my garage, and they're really the nuts and bolts and electronics and mechatronics and robots. But the interesting thing is it's very clear that a lot of the members come along for the social aspect. They like to interact and collaborate on the work that they do. For me, the other members are very polite, and they say, isn't it an imposition? They're sort of coming around in the garage and houses and that. It's like every Tuesday for 5 hours, people come around to my house and do mad stuff. It's fantastic. The other week, a young student came around and he'd taken a laser printer and he modified it physically so he could run a stiff printed circuit board through an HP laser printer, and it would print the circuit straight onto the copper and just throw it in the back. The young guy just rocked up and shown us this stuff. It's amazing what people do. And the best thing about Hackerspace is it's taking all the things you know and love in the software world and applying them to real world things. And so just automating, making the world do stuff. From today, you'd think it was all just about getting rid of electronic circuit boards and making rocket avionics and stuff that sounds a bit daunting at first. But really, it's a really broad scope. It's pretty much everything in the world is hackable in some sense. Like a cake decorating machine or wearable computing, or if you want to let your dog in and out through a dog door, or just practical problems, or you're really ticked off at some company that locks up the hardware so they can't do stuff with it. Everything can be reused. So rather than taking things that are broken and throwing them out, use them again, do something interesting with them. And the environment's one where the very experienced people are very, very giving of their time, helping people who are new to something. And often there's someone who's maybe quite experienced in hardware gets helped out by someone who's got no hardware experience but knows a lot about software or can mill things with a milling machine or it's good or work. So everyone helps each other out. So you don't have to come along feeling like it's only for experts. The main benefit of Hackerspace is that it's a group that works in a physical space. So we aim to have access to tools and equipment that you wouldn't normally be able to afford or justify yourself. A drill press, maybe you use it once a year, but if it's in a Hackerspace, it gets used most weeks. Or maybe an oscilloscope that costs more than it makes sense to have just for your own personal use. There's also people who've got a broad range of skills. They may learn a lot about music and doing something, some music instrument hack, or they're good with putting Android onto some strange device. The other area that's good is people collaborating on projects that require multiple skills and that will run for 6 months or a year. It's good to have a space for me to do that sort of stuff. And our Hackerspace meets every week for about 5 hours and a week and a month, so it's a lot of contact time, and you just need a physical space for people to do that and leave their gear around. Over the last 2 years, a number of Hackerspaces have sprung up in all the major cities. I think it's even one like in maybe like Townsville and Newcastle.
And Perth.
And singing? I forgot Perth, my apologies. Daniel in the room or something. That's it. Sorry, Perth, it was there, I think I did a Control-Z mistake. Perth Art Factory, my apologies. But the main thing is you go to hackerspaces.org, and the wiki has a list of Hackerspaces all around the world. And if you happen to travel, basically just look it up and find a lot of Hackerspaces, particularly like in San Francisco, which is Noise Bridge, or New York, NYC Resistor, or Chaos Computer Club in Germany, where it all sort of began. And you'll find a friendly environment of hackers just doing stuff, so it's like a home away from home. And we've had people rock up from Belgium, Germany, places in America and stuff. It's pretty cool. I'm probably going to spend most of our time. Find a Hackerspace, come along. We have group projects. If people can't think something, do we have group projects that we can involve with, or if we're an individual project? So, that's my statement.
Thank you.
Things printed with a 3D printer. I'll be around to look at that sort of stuff. This is the project that Lucinda will be recording next year. This is some rocket avionics, but it's a general telemetry board, so you basically put it on your push bike or your cat. where it's going and how fast that cat is and in which neighbours it's going. This is for a general display, put push buttons inside from last year's community comp. So basically, this board will talk to the telemetry board for Downlink. A route that we had to put a Nintendo touchscreen on, displaying sensors and runs open WRT. So, it's just making mad stuff and having fun. Thank you.